aka GK Braylon. Call me Glenda, please. Pardon my hand. Cheesy smile. Sorry, I just did a treatment. Which reminds me, I didn't take my meds that keep me from shaking so bad, so I'll have to do that yet. Anyway, has anybody heard from Sophia lately? I hope she's still watching, but I don't know what's happening with her family and her grandfather. I'm hoping that they're getting through it. Okay. Anyway, we have a new viewer. I won't name her yet because she hasn't given me permission to. But she's having trouble. Her husband has an inherited or genetic type of COPD that was recently diagnosed. They're around 70 years old. I believe she said 71. And he's getting kind of at a point where he's not able to do as much. And it's progressing a little fast with him. Well, she's not, I don't know about how fast, but faster than what some of us do, I guess. I don't understand all the biology behind it or the physiology, but I did recommend she go to see copdfoundation.org, which I always recommend to you guys. And but please welcome her. She commented on yesterday's page, and so all of you supporters out there, you're so great at that, and I just love that so much. I can just say so much, and then the rest is, you know, a lot of it is what you guys do, and you support me. And she's the caregiver, and I know some of you have been the caregiver. The caregiving I've done has been in a professional capacity, so it's not the same as when it's family. And I know Glenda Wilson has done that, and I know that it was, from what the way she's talked, that it was not easy. And so anyway, she's a good soother. She's a good spirit. So, but I welcome all of you who watch and maybe haven't subscribed or you haven't commented or whatever. It's you know, that part's totally up to you. I'd like you to subscribe. We've had another increase in subscriptions, and I would like to keep going, get that up to 100 at least. I've submitted through Patreon. I'm not sure yet how that's working because, well, I'm just learning the ropes, and I don't know how well that's going to work for me, but we'll see. Just be able to keep my equipment up and do what I'm doing is my main goal there. So anyway, they like my, well, anyways, I got a story about my husband anyway. A little bit ago. Hearing anyway, he's making fun of me, but I get to get him back. A little bit ago, I had this little camera and I was pointing it at him. He heard the little noise when I turned it on. And I was, I don't want that, I don't have my teeth in, don't film me, I don't like that. And I just kept pointing it at him, it wasn't recording. But I got his goat anyway. I did finally tell him, well, it's not recording, before he got too wound up. He was just sitting there laughing. But I always like to make him sound like he's just panicking. He's doing my anyways for me. You guys like my well anyways. That's my tag. or whatever they call that. That's my line. That's okay. He's married to me. He can say, well, anyway, or anyway, because I do that a lot. It's my It's my I don't know what to say next. Anyway, furthermore, I was up until about 6:30 this morning uploading yesterday's vlog, which you're seeing today. Well, you're seeing while I'm recording this. Anyway, me and that word. We had a storm last night, and it kept knocking out the internet. And I wasn't the only one, because my neighbor's internet kept going down, too, because it'll tell me which ones are close. Of course, we all keep ours secured, so there's no way I can fudge off anybody. I keep mine secured as well. But it does help me to know whether or not it's just me, or if we're down in the whole, you know. So I did reset and re-plug in all my stuff on my router, but it finally stayed on. And I fell asleep a couple of times. I just couldn't hold it anymore. Somewhere now he's doing his, now he's spitting raspberries at me. I'm gonna put him on camera if he keeps this stuff up. He's laughing. He's daring me. He really is. But I went to bed, got under my CPAP at about 6:30 this morning. And with the spotty sleep I got, I kept waking up. It was like sleeping with one eye open, except it was like, I gotta wake up and make sure that's still going. Because my pewter, my computer, that's what we talk to our little grandkids, or when we're being funny. My pewter, it'll go to sleep if I don't keep at it, so. And this, let me show you this. Finished it yesterday, had it on, was gonna show it off. And then, you can see the beads rolling off. I'm trying to keep them from doing that. It broke at the crimper again. I'm gonna go back to thread. I have thread. I wasn't using it because I thought wire would be better. And generally, I think that's probably true. But I have a nice strong thread. There's this color and there's white. And I am just gonna go on this one. I'm tired of wire. Going back to thread. I always think I'm not gonna do anything entertaining. I don't think I have anything entertaining. But then this stuff happens, and I know it's more funny to you than it is to me. Oh, no, it's good to get a good laugh. Always get a good laugh. Always get a good laugh. For some reason. Laugh at yourself is the best way. But if your husband's giving you guff, you can laugh at him too and give it back. So. Well, anyway, I'll see you on the pewter. Hi. Do I look professional? Do I look like a real radio person? Well, weather rainy. News. It's Saturday. And I could cross my eyes. Oh.
And sports, I'm not running any. Oh, golly. Ding-a-ling-a-ling. You turned it off. Yes, I took off my headphones and it gives a ding-a-ling-a-ling. But, see, even those, my hair's just a mess. I don't know if you really call it a mess. It's just everywhere. It's that kind of hair that it can bug me to death. But, I don't know. These days, bedheads are still in. I don't know. These guys on some of these deals have been talking about some kind of gel in a little pot that they use to, you know, fix their hair and stuff like that. But we used to use dippity-doo. That stuff would dry so hard that you could be one of those plastic-haired people in the... okay. I think it's time for me to say goodnight. I don't really have a whole lot more except to tell you, you guys are a nasty mirror when I look at this camera. Well, the camera is. You guys are sweet as can be. You guys give me so much better, make me feel much better than this stupid computer screen looking at me does, because it's me looking at me. Yeah. we never like our own reflections, do we? Well, some do. Anyway, yeah, I'm going to say goodnight here so I can start uploading. And I didn't have anything profound today, but I think I had some fun. I hope maybe there was a little comedy for you, if nothing else. But I did want to bring, if you look at this gal's comments about her husband's COPD, she's just having a rough time, and she's got support, don't get me wrong, she's got support from her family and stuff, but you know, it's hard to find people who have been through, and she explains it better than I can in her comments from yesterday. So please read what she had to say and support her. It's hard. I haven't had to do that, but I can certainly imagine. You know, I mean, well, you know, it's not the same as taking care of a sick kid, but because it's your spouse. But darn, when you've got a really sick kid. You know, my son had an accident one time, just scared the heck out of me. And, you know, so I can just, all I can do is use my imagination to think how that must feel for any person. And my husband, he's not a complainer, but I know he's given up a lot for me, so. Anyway, I love you. I care. Truly, I do. And I will see you tomorrow. I hope. Which means the same thing as hasta mañana!